A public and political backlash has forced the government to do an embarrassing budget backflip and reverse its decision to slash the solar panel rebate. 10 reporter Silvana Sikorski joins us live from Parliament House. And Silvana, what can you tell us?
Yes, good evening, Nerelda. It was one of the most unpopular decisions to come out of the state budget last week, halving the solar feed-in tariff. The decision sparked community outrage, with West Australians questioning the Premier's integrity. Today, the Premier announced that decision has been reversed, a move which appears to have taken Treasurer Troy Buswell by surprise.
The day after the state budget was handed down, Troy Buswell stood firm. The decision to cut the solar rebate was final.
Are you tearing that contract up?
Yes.
The Treasurer walking into this morning's Cabinet meeting adamant that was still the case.
The budget decisions have been made and we're now moving on, focusing on implementing them.
But less than 30 minutes later, the government admitted they got it wrong.
I apologise. I'm sorry this happened. It was a mistake. We accept that. We reversed the decision and I guess we move on from there.
Last week, 75,000 West Australians who'd invested in solar energy were left stunned. They'd signed up to receive 40 cents for every unit of electricity they pumped back into the grid for 10 years. The Treasurer said he was cutting that in half, ending the deal. Today's turn came as a great relief for those who signed up.
To try and pull the rug out from under it was pretty low, I thought, and I'm glad they saw the sense and overturn their decision.
The Premier received pressure from within his party, with backbencher Rob Johnson threatening to cross the floor if the decision wasn't reversed.
It's all down to the fact that the Premier has been advised by his advisers, you can't go ahead with this because it will kill us. Politically, it will kill us.
The government says Synergy didn't make it clear to the public the contract was subject to change.
If Mr Barnett is saying the contracts can still be changed, well, people with solar panels need to be very frightened.
The move would have saved the government $50 million and today the Premier insisted the scheme was flawed and overly generous, but promised it would continue.
We, this government, will make no more changes to it. But that's it.
Silvana Sikorski, 10 News.